Charles Darwin was that famous white-bearded scientist who went on a dangerous voyage around the world on the HMS Beagle. On this trip, he collected a shipload of data in the form of plant and animal specimens. Darwin then used these specimens to think about his theory of evolution by natural selection. This box, called a vasculum, went with Darwin on that daring voyage and was used to protect delicate plants collected in the field. The vasculum played an important role in maintaining and preserving the physical characteristics of the plant, such as petal arrangement, and allowed Darwin to investigate these characteristics later in greater detail, within a more practical environment like his study and not a boat.
My name's Alex Monroe. I'm a botanist and a fellow of the Linnean Society. By collecting data on the form and shape of plants and on DNA, we can use that to compare how related they are to each other. That will enable us to create hypotheses about how they evolved.
The Galapagos Archipelago, a series of volcanic islands, is home to a variety of prickly pear cacti. These cacti are eaten by tortoises, who have pretty hearty appetites. Tall varieties of the prickly pear cacti grow on islands with giant tortoises, whereas shorter varieties grow on islands with no tortoises. When Darwin compared the leaves of the cacti he'd collected from the Galapagos with leaves of the cacti he'd collected from South America, he noticed they were both paddle-shaped, so must be closely related. Darwin theorized that the plants in the Galapagos must have been transported to the island as seeds, via wind, water, or carried by an animal, maybe on its fur, feathers, or in its feces. Because of the island's distance from the mainland, these plants then became isolated, and over a long period of time, evolved to be much taller than their mainland relatives, so they could avoid being eaten by those savage prickly pear-obsessed tortoises.
The reason they support us to collect plants is that we share this planet with about 350,000 species of them, and yet for the vast majority we know very little. By collecting them in the field, we can start to understand how they help maintain the living world around us.
The living things that Darwin collected formed the data on which he was able to formulate his theory of evolution by natural selection. Powerful theories such as these still depend on the collation of large amounts of data, and so the importance of collecting plants is still crucial today.